In this video, we're going to talk about latch and trigger modes. Now, I have a multi setup with sounds on 6 of the parts. And you'll recall way back at the beginning of this series when we were looking at each part that there's trigger and latch buttons here on the main page for each part where we can enable latch mode by clicking on it and set a trigger mode. Well, we're going to look at it in a bit more detail here, and we're going to look at it in the context of using it with stack mode, and it can be used with live mode as well, which we're going to look at in another video. But for now, we're in stack mode, and I have my multi setup with 6 patches, and I've got them mapped out. I'm in notes mode here. I've got a couple of them mapped out over this range here so that they'll layer together, a couple of mapped out on that range so they'll layer together with some different crossfades, and I have one at the top. Now, right now, we're just working in regular mode, and I can hit a note, and you'll hear, for example, down low, I'm hearing both of those pitches, and you can see the notes I'm hitting on my controller here. On this keyboard, we're seeing all the notes that are generated via the arpeggiators, but here's the actual notes that I'm triggering. So I lift my finger, and it stops. Hit in a higher range, and I'm triggering these. Hit higher. And I'm triggering that one. Now we can right click on the parts and put on latch mode. And I'm going to do it on these 2 low parts. And what that means is you can hit the note, lift your finger off the note, and it will continue playing. So it frees your hands up to trigger, in this case, let's say an arpeggiated part, and then maybe play in a higher range another part to accompany it. Now the way to stop the note from repeating is to hit the same note again. So for example, I'm going to hit a low C here. And you can see the notes that I'm triggering on my keyboard here, and these are the notes that are generated from your arpeggiator. So you can see my finger is off the note, but it's still sustaining. The way to stop it is to hit that same note again. I'll hit C2 again, and it stopped. For example, here's an F, and you can see I'm not sustaining it, but it's still playing. Hit it again, and it stopped it. Now, if you lose track of what note you've hit, you can always right click and go all notes off, and that'll stop playback. Now I'm going to enable latch mode for all of these, and I'm going to combine it with trigger mode. And by the way, we'll look now in these parts and you'll see that latch mode is enabled in all of these parts by virtue of enabling them there. And we can enable it in either place, of course. So in stack mode, I'm now going to set up trigger mode, which means trigger immediate is the default, meaning as soon as you hit the note, it's going to play. But I'm going to set it up for next beat so that it'll automatically quantize on input what you're playing. And you can optionally use next beat, next bar, or next 16th note. And I'm going to do this for now. And we can then create a kind of real-time performance triggering parts on and off. I'm going to hit the sequencer so we can hear a kick drum doing quarter notes. And I'll try and play something in real time for you. And you can keep track here of what notes I'm actually playing on the keyboard. So there you can see how you can generate a real-time performance using latch mode to hit a note, lift your finger off, and free it up to play another part while the initial part sustains. And it's particularly useful with arpeggiated patterns. And trigger mode to quantize on input when the notes are going to start so that they're in sync. Again, particularly effective with rhythmic material. See you for more in the next video.